I've been highly elated, but also humble and proud to see this, those ones of engineers, builders, who are the ones that make Abuja as a city chief, and we thank you very much. Every building you see in this city, whether it's public or private, has an input of your members. I would like your members to welcome all this training here. I spent some time to discuss upstairs regarding the significance of today. And I think Nigerian Institute of Business have done very well to decide to use 13th March 2020 as a day to commemorate what happened. Exactly, I do. Sadly, in Lagos. With a strong institute like your own, I think gradually, as time goes by, building collapse will be peaceful in Nigeria. During our discussion, I appreciate and thank you on behalf of the SET administration for the support we got from the Institute last year or 2 years ago when they did a survey within the Abuja to identify buildings that had been commenced many years ago but had not been completed as well as the abandonment. And based on that report, we have now started the process of ensuring that all these buildings go through an interactive test. And in the process, a number of them will be proven. All this is the best of the effort. Thank you. I also mentioned to you that it's very important that your members and all of you, particularly the up, young, vibrant business coming up, insist on quality. Even if it's going to cost the income that you are going to get from that building. Because at the end of the day, every building is meant to serve humanity. So that's why, even if the architects try to make a design, once you go there, first and foremost, look at it. Does it cater for everybody? Is it a building that is inclusive? Does it take care of the physically handicapped? Has it been planned in such a way that it can have natural aeration? Has it been planned in such a way that you can have alternative source of power? As if you plan in such a way that you can park properly. If you go around many of the buildings, even in Abuja, in spite of the planning, you find beautiful buildings, but you realize that they never really properly make arrangement for parking. But these are things that we expect your generation of builders to now become more focused and more firm in making sure that whatever you build is inclusive and it's also a building that will cater for the welfare. People, not for the people to get up for the welfare of the building. Thank you very much.